Hello guys, so today I'm going to show you how to create a ball game using Unity Game Engine. This is a very fun and interesting beginner project, so be sure to watch it till the end. If you enjoy this video, consider subscribing, it's free and you can always change your mind later. Create a new Unity 3D project. Now we want to create a platform so our ball can roll on it. So let's right click at the hierarchy and select plane. And then name it ground. So let's reset the plane transform. So click the three dot over here and set reset. Now it will in the position of 0, 0, and 0. Now let's increase its scale to 2, 1, and 2. So make it bigger. And then we want to make the plane have a grass color. So let's right click at the assets down here and then select material. Let's name it grass. And now you can also Google for the color or just select right here. So I want to change it to grass and then apply it right by drag it to the object. The second thing we want to include in our project is the player that we want to control. So let's create a sphere because we want our player to be a ball, and let's name it player. Now let's reset its position. So click transform and click reset. Make it higher a bit so a Y will be 2. Now let's create some material for our player. So right click the same and do the same as the grass material. So name it player material and change the color to blue. Apply it, and now we have a sphere. And we want to add a physics component, which is rigid body. And now if you run the program, you will see that it's fall down. Okay, so now we want to create a script for our player. So to make the player move, let's right click here, click create, and then select C# script and name it player movement. Let's load it, drag it to the player, and then if you scroll down, you will see that the player have a script component. Now you want to double click the script so you can open it. So let's wait a bit. After you create the script, you want to create a new function named fixedUpdate, because fixedUpdate is where we use our physics. So void fixedUpdate bracket and then angle bracket. So before we put any contents in the fixedUpdate, we want to get the rigid body of the player, the component, the rigid body component. So you need to type public rigid body RB. So this is the data type and this is the variable. And then when you control S, which is save the program and back to our Unity project, if you click on the player, you will see that there's a variable named RB and the box is say none. So which we need to put a rigid body component into it. So now let's drag our player rigid body right here, and now it's applied. To move the player, we want to use the add force function. So let's type rb.addForce. So now this function takes three parameters, which is the x, y, and z force. So we want our player to move in one direction, so you can choose x or z. So I'll choose the z. So you want to 0 on the x, 0 on the y, and you want to put something in the z. So you need to create another public variable. So public float movement speed, and it will be equal to 1500f. And then down here we want to type movement speed multiplied with time dot delta time. Now if you run the program, I missed a semicolon. Okay, so at force, capital F. Okay, so now when you run the program or the project, you will see that the ball is going forward in the Z direction. So if we go to the player transform right here, if we move in this, we are going in the Z direction. Because our camera is looking at this direction, so we see that the ball is going toward the Z axis. But now we want to control our player. So when we click the up arrow or W, it will move forward. And if we press the S button or the down arrow, it will move backward. So let's add a if statement. So if, and we want to type input.getKey, and in the bracket we want to type the name of the key. So let's say up, which is the up arrow, angle bracket, and let's put our rb.addForce in it, and then let's save the project. And now we want to make our camera above our game object so we can see the entire scene. Let's make it higher and then let's change its angle to 30 degrees, maybe just 20, I think. We'll make it higher a little bit. Okay, so now if we run the program, and okay, so when I click the up arrow, it will move forward. And now let's add another one. So if the down arrow is pressed, we don't want the movement speed multiplied time by delta time. We want negative movement speed, so it will move backward. Let's save it. Let's play the program. And now when you click the up arrow, it will move forward, and if you click the down arrow, it will move backward. So it's perfect. Now you may ask, how could I move left to the left and to the right? So you can just copy and paste this two if statement, and let's change down to left to right, and then copy this, and instead of the Z, we want to in the X axis. Same for the right one. And okay, let's change the negative sign to the plus sign or nothing. Now let's run it, see if it works. Okay, let's press play and let's see what happened. Now okay, so it's a bit of a reverse, so we need to change this to negative and this is positive. Let's run it again. So now we are fully control our player. So the player can move forward if we press the up key, and move backward if we press the down key. Perfect. So this is the end of this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And in the next video, I will show you guys how to create an obstacle course for your player, and I will show you how to make the player jump. So see you next time. Bye.